Stay tuned because come.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
National News Stories Making Headlines today. And it's Wednesday, October 19th, 2011.
I'm Michelle, and with me today is Lily Smalls. On today's show, we'll take a look at what Oakcrest graduate will soon be enshrined on the Wall of Fame at Oakcrest, and where you'll want to be Saturday, October 29th, if you don't have anything to do.
We've got those stories just ahead, including a look at what exactly makes teens such bad drivers, and that's just ahead in National News with Chris.
I can't wait to see why I'm such a bad driver, but if you can't wait or can't stick around to see, be sure to visit our YouTube channel and Twitter to get to caught up on missed episodes.
For those Oakcrest stories and others, visit the Falcon TV web channel right here on YouTube where you can catch up on the past everything episodes of Everything Oakcrest. Our channels update daily, and it features other shows not seen on our show.
If there are stories or announcements you want to see featured on our show, don't forget that you can find us on Twitter or email us. Our email address is talentproductions@yahoo.com and is at the bottom of the screen. All right, let's head over to Chris and see what stories are making headlines in national news today.
There was some national news. All over the country, young drivers have been getting criticized for all their driving. Older people say that teenagers are unsafe and get distracted too fast, while some drivers disagree with that. Researchers conducted a new study about how drivers disagree 100%. Most states have graduated laws that require young drivers to only have one passenger in the car and wait until a certain age to receive their license, like a Jersey where you have to be 18. A recent study shows that fine laws that probably haven't been going to change anytime soon because they're actually working a new road safer. Here is a closer look of what the studies have found.
Well, underscores how distraction and inexperience are the consistent problem factors in teenage driving. From loud music and a missed stop sign to texting with mom in the car.
Don't text while you're driving.
Speeding through a school zone.
Whoa, don't hit me, car.
Talking on the phone, driving down the middle of the road, even unbuckling and reaching for a bag while making a turn. Now, new AAA research shows that teens are 50% more likely to have a crash in the first month of driving without a parent on board than they are after driving with a full year of experience.
But as soon as that parent leaves the car and the child starts driving by themselves, the risks jump up dramatically.
Take it easy on the corner.
I am.
AAA's cameras followed 38 teens from permit to full license. Chuck Cotati saved his daughter Leah from a very serious accident.
Whoa, stop! Hit your brakes!
What were they doing?
They completely ran a red light. All right, go now. Completely ran a red light.
Today, all 50 states and D.C. ease teens into the driver's seat with graduated driver's licenses, usually including restrictions on nighttime driving and passengers, with full driving privileges coming at the age of 16 in some states, 17 and 18 in others. Something's working. Teen driving-related fatalities have dropped from 6,100 in 2002 to 2,800 in 2009. Miami-Dade Police Sergeant David Greenwall investigates fatal accidents.
Just the inattention to driving for a few seconds could cost you your life or could cost someone else's life.
The lesson learned is that behind the wheel, there is no substitute for experience.
Chris will be honoring its alumni with special tribute events. The first on the schedule is the premiere of the motion picture Mighty Max, the story of alumni Oakcrest Kathy Rush and her rise to fame in college basketball. She was the first coach of the women's basketball championship team and is also National Basketball Hall of Fame. Aside from battling cancer, she's been an inspiration to women all across the country and is being remembered for her work in this film, which comes out October 21st nationwide.
If you can't make it out there to support that movie and an Oakcrest graduate, there's another film coming up that features about 50 of them, a feature-length documentary produced by Oakcrest Media titled Oakcrest High School, A History of Excellence, will premiere on Monday, October 24th at 6:30 p.m.
The film features in-depth interviews as well as never-seen-before footage of the building, so be sure to take the time out and carry on the 50-year celebration right here in Oakcrest Auditorium. Let's take a look at what you can expect.
Thank you.
Again, the documentary will premiere on Monday, October 24th at 6:30 p.m.
For even more Oak Ridge graduates being honored for their achievements, this year's annual Wall of Fame induction ceremony will be held on October 28th during halftime of the football game. This year's class of inductees is a strong group from different decades, and here today to tell us about more, one of them is former phys ed teacher Miss Betty Howe.
One of the new inductees onto the Wall of Fame, and that's Sherry Vaughn Miller. During my first years of coaching and teaching here at Oak Crest High School, it was my privilege to have some of the best athletes I ever had all during my 37 years as a coach at Oak Crest. Back in the 70s, when women were striving for some identity in sports and were really fighting to get recognition, Sherry Vaughn stood out. She played softball, she played field hockey, and she played basketball. And if I have to refer to my notes, it's only because she was so outstanding and won so many awards that I don't want to forget any of the important ones. She was captain in all three sports. In field hockey, she was most valuable player. She was all-star team in all 4 years, which means as a freshman, she was elected to the all-star team. She was best all around in 2 years. As basketball, she made first team all conference, first team all press, first team all courier post. She was elected the best offensive player and the best defensive player. She graduated from Oak Crest High School and she went on to ACC, where she was elected as the most valuable female basketball player and female athlete of the year. For hockey, she was elected to the National Junior College Athletic second team. That means throughout the whole country, she was one of the top 30 players. Besides being an excellent athlete, she was also an outstanding individual. She was in the Girls Athletic Association. She was a member of many activities at Oak Crest High School. And just walking the halls, everybody looked up to Sherry Vaughn. She was just an outstanding person. And she's continued in that tradition. We have been lucky enough to have her three children, who two of them graduated from here and one of them is now at Cedar Creek, who are also outstanding athletes. And I would like to welcome Sherry Vaughn to the Wall of Fame and tell her that it's a well-deserved award that she's receiving this year. Thank you.
For the Wall of Fame inductions is a great opportunity to something and to help someone in need. On October 25th, Oak Crest High School and the National Honor Society will hold their annual fall blood drive, and they need your help to stop the national blood supply shortage.
It is an easy way to get involved and donate. If you want to donate, there's only one thing you need to do.
Sign up.
You're at least 16. All you have to do is fill out a slip and with a member of the NHS or see Mr. Lockwood to get a donation time.
If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song. Uh-oh, uh-oh. Lord, make me a rainbow, I'll shine down on my mother. She'll know I'm safe with you when she stands under my colors. Oh, and life ain't always what you think it ought to be. No, ain't even gray, but she buries her baby. The sharp knife of a short life. Well, I've had just enough time. If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song.
Visiting their competition. First up, the varsity girls soccer team will hit the road to play Lower Cape May High School in an away game, and the varsity girls tennis team will also be on the road in an away match against Ocean City.
The varsity and JV field hockey teams will both play a game versus OC, and finally, the varsity JV boys soccer teams will both play St. Augustine Prep. Good luck to all those teams. All those games begin at 4 p.m.
It may only be October, but for most baseball players, there will be a meeting on Thursday, October 20th in Coach Service Room, which is 306, and that meeting will be right after school, where they will discuss the selling of Thanksgiving pies sponsored by the Baseball Booster Club.
Also, today, a preseason wrestling meeting in room 222 will be held for all interested in returning wrestlers. And in a meeting for 335 at 245 is girls basketball, who will talk about physicals and tryouts, and interested players will have an opportunity to meet the coaches.
Also, when it comes to supporting your favorite teams, make sure you stop to the media studio and pick up a Falcon Pride wristband. And take advantage of the big sale. It is 2 for $3. When you buy 2 wristbands, you'll save $1. Get 2 wristbands for $3 today and only while supplies last.
In clubs and meetings today, there's a GAA has a meeting after school in room 201, and the French Club also has a meeting on the same day in Ms. Shaver's room, where elections will be also held. Today, if you're staying after school, there will only be 3:30 buses.
For upcoming events, attention to all seniors. Homecoming will be November 19th at 7 p.m., and the price is $15 per person. Tickets will be sold November 14th through the 17th, and you can buy them during your lunch. All the money raised will go to the ASPCA. This year's theme is Midnight Garden. See Ms. Delarengo or Ms. Kennedy for permission slips and details.
For other events that are right around the corner, the annual Student Council / Drama Haunted Walk is also here. It's almost here. Every year, the drama students collaborate with the Student Council to put together an awesomely scary show for just a few bucks. And this year, Hamilton Township is even working Oakhurst to promote the event. The big headline of year's events is that it will be held on Saturday, so everyone can attend. So if you're up for a big scare and don't have anything to do October 29th, make sure you come out here and support the Oakhurst event.
Walker, interviewing John Birch, told about the Haunted Walk upcoming this year.
How long has the Haunted Walk been actually going on here at Oakhurst?
I'm not sure on an exact number. I think around 8 years, but it's kind of one of those Oakhurst traditions that just have been around for a long time, so.
Okay. What is actually the Haunted Walk?
Like the theme?
Yes.
The theme is the Fear Factory. It's basically this old dilapidated factory in the forest, and inside it produces fear. So each person experiences it differently, whether you're scared of clowns, spiders, the dark, anything. So when you're inside the Fear Factory, you will come in contact with your deepest fears.
That sounds really interesting. How do you actually set it up?
Well, it takes a lot of planning. I've actually been planning since August, because the Haunted Walk is one of my favorite events. You have to think about what kind of scenes you're going to have, and you have to let your scene leaders know, and they have to pick people. They have to spend money, spend time on their scenes, and make it the best they can make it.
What day is the Haunted Walk on?
This year it's actually on a Saturday, October 29th, and it's actually going to be an all-day event. So from 3 to 5 we're going to have kids events, and then at night starting at 7, from 7 to 10 we're going to have the actual Haunted Walk.
So this is the first time you did it here at Oakhurst, right?
No.
On a Saturday?
On a Saturday.
Saturday. Yeah. Okay. Where can you purchase the tickets?
You can actually buy them at the door this year. So bring your friends, bring your family, everyone, and they can come.
All right, well, thank you, John.
Thank you.
Don't forget to purchase your tickets October 29th for the Haunted Walk this year. It's on a Saturday.
Again, that's OHA's Falcon TV on Twitter.
Also, visit our Falcon TV website for the latest updates on everything Oakhurst, including the news section on our homepage that will let you know what's happening each day this week at Oakhurst. Our website is at the bottom of the screen, and you can also get to us through the Oakhurst webpage.
That was your news for Wednesday, and thanks for watching today. For Lily Smalls, Chris, and everyone else here at the Falcon TV studio, have a great day, and we'll see you back here tomorrow. I'm Michelle, and this is Falcon TV News. Have a great day. It was a sentence for